Given the lack of action on this, how can regular people best mobilize to protect our democracy before hopefully there's another chance, perhaps in the next Congress?
Listen, first of all, I'm not completely convinced that this is over in Congress. I am the person who fights until the bitter end, but also understand that there have been lots of changes at the state and local level due to the lack of action rates. We've this year alone just seen what 13 states have already enacted anti-voting bills. We've had over 500, nearly 600 bills actually restricting the freedom to vote be introduced in 40 states. Like, this is still a fight that people are having every day at home. So first piece of advice, one, find out what's happening in your state right now. Find out what laws have been passed since the 2020 elections to change the way that you are going to be able to access the ballot. Most, I'm sure, states have some sort of changes that have been made. So please find out what's happening and how that's going to affect you. Also, find out who did it. I think Michael still said it nicely, but I won't say it nicely. Make them pay. We are at a point where our democracy is at stake. We are, and if we do not fight for it, we will not be able to recognize the state of this country in just a few years. And if we are not all participating and making people pay for trying to take away our right to vote, for trying to take away our access to the ballot, for trying to take away things like Sunday voting and souls to the polls and early voting and vote by mail during a pandemic, if we're not making people pay for literally taking Black and brown voters out of the equation and diluting their vote, if we're not making them pay for all of the things, for giving corporate lobbyists too much influence, for giving corporations way too much influence in our elections, we will not recognize our democracy. And I wish that I was not being hyperbolic by saying this, but we are. We are seeing the effects of what lack of action and by lack of continued action is going to have on our country. And I say continued action because voting is one action, but holding people accountable and watching them as they're in office is the other part. So we all have a job to do. I'm not going to just leave it on Representative Sarbanes and Representative Jones to do this work. This is our country. This is our work. And it is up to all of us to find out what is going on and to do something about it.